I'm so happy you can make it tonight. Make some noise for Shiv Patel, everybody! Yeah!
Yo, yo, yo! So guys, I'm 22, you know, which means I have to start talking to girls. Because that's just something you do when you get with one, you know. But it stopped me talking to girls because of the fear of rejection. You know, for example, I asked this girl out the other day, and she was like, "Yeah," and I was like, "Really?" And she was like, "No, no, no." She didn't know the first time, and it pissed me off. Not to a point where I wish her a lot of malice in her life, but just to a point where I wish her a lot of minor inconveniences throughout the rest of her life. You know, like I hope that the next time she takes a shower, her towel's still wet from the last shower. I think that could be diabolical. You feel the pain on that one. Or I hope that the next time someone waves at her, that person's actually waving to the person in back. And then that could ruin everything. Or I hope that the next time she's on the train, it hits her dad. He doesn't die. You know? She does. Because she was the one who created the. Or he dies. She doesn't. Because then that would cause her emotion. Both of them die. Both of them deserve to die. And if that's like what should be happen. No, none of them die. It's just an imagination exercise. But I was very angry that it happened. It's also tough talking to girls, guys, because I look very young. You know, like I'm 22, but I look like I'm 12. Which is why a lot of the times I try and grow a beard out. You know, the only problem then is that I start to look a little bit like a terrorist, you know? So it's a lose-lose situation. You know, either I look like a little kid, or I look like a terrorist. You know, either I look like a little brown boy, or I look like an Indian with a couple of bombs in his pockets. You know? Which I actually happen to bring with me in my pockets today! Comedy show. They're not in my pockets, you know. They're actually just strapped to my chest. No kidding. They're not. I don't have them. Don't worry. I don't have them. I don't personally have bombs, you know. But my brother does. And he's out here supporting me. You guys better see him before he sees you. Or else he might activate it. No, he's not here. There's no bomb. I'm not a terrorist, you know. And you guys don't know whether or not I am. That's the whole point of being one, you know. Whether or not I am. As far as you guys know, you don't know. And that's the beauty of it. I'm not. I think I have to clarify that before I move on and let the cops come. But guys, it is tough talking to girls, probably because I do that bit. It's tough talking to girls. Weird bit to do. Like for example, I was in Cabo the other week on spring break, and I saw this girl in a club. And I don't know about you guys, but I've never been grinded on before, you know. So like, as she started coming over to me, she brushed up against my thigh and it tickled. So I laughed. I was like, you know. And she started grinding, and she found that weird. But I got so nervous that she continued to go harder into the grind. I just said, "Mama raised you better than that," you know. And she's like, "Oh no, she didn't." Like, "You're right, she didn't. You're continuing to gyrate on my thighs." So it was definitely weird. I asked another girl out on another day because there's a lot of them. On Earth, there's a lot of, they're like 50% of the population, you know. So I asked her out, and she said no, which I have no idea why. You know, I mean, I even wrote "I love you" in the email subject line. You know, I emailed her. Like, I don't know if this, have you ever been email asked out before? No, exactly. I wanted to be that one guy who slid into her Yahoo mail. People in my house Yahoo apparently means vagina. I didn't know that. So Yahoo Mail, that's a little dirty. But it is tough time to be, it's a little tough time to be girls because of my voice. You know, like, this voice doesn't say boyfriend, it says friend. You know, it doesn't say husband, it says bachelor. You know, I'll go up to girls and I'll be like, hey, how are ya? You know, how are you doing today? You know, and then they run away because they're like, that's not a guy, that's not a dude. You know, that's not a dude talking to me at all. I asked another girl out on Mother Day, and there's a lot of them, and I was like, I introduced myself, I'm like, hey, my name is Shiv, and then she's just like, Shuv? I'm like, no, Shiv. And then she's just like, Shuv? And I'm like, no, usually you adjust the pronunciation after you get it wrong the first time. It's just something a non-dumb person would do. And then I give her one more shot. I'm like, it's Shiv. And then she's just like, Shoo? And I'm like, this isn't going to work. This is not going to happen. I don't think this will be a long-term thing. A lot of people in college are talking about sex. They're like, yo, bro, what's your body count? And I'm like, well, I haven't killed anyone in my life yet. You know, so I don't really, except for in GTA, that's the only place where I've really done it. And he's just like, no, I mean, how many people have you actually had sex with? And I'm like, oh, I've had sex with neuro people. He's like, you've had sex with neuro people? Like, no, except for in GTA. That's the only Grand Theft Auto. That's the only place where I've had sex. They're in the video game. And he's just like, but how many people have you actually been? I've had sex with none. He's like, you've had sex with a nun. And I'm like, no. Except for in GTA. Grand Theft Auto. That's the only place. There was a nice chapel. I couldn't control my impulses in the video game. Guys, that's my time. Thank you so much for listening. Bye.